That's how cold it is. We got ice in the wok.
I knew it was cold this whole time, but that's confirmed to me how cold it is. Right, as you can probably tell, it's bloody freezing. It's -8 with no heating, so I'm sorry I'm not outside for this week's episode, so I need to stay warm. It's been ages since the last Tai Chi family episode, and I, unfortunately, for personal reasons, has gone away. She didn't tell me she was leaving, I was off doing a walk, so she may be back, she may not, but that's why she hasn't been in the videos. But for this video, I want to show how different life is in rural China when it snows. So let's start off with water.
The water is not in a good way.
That basically means the toilets aren't running either, so we got to do the old squat style.
It's the classic countryside squatter.
I really need to do some washing because I did the Chengdu trip and that's about a week's worth of clothes. And I've only got like 3 sets of clothes.
But the water's frozen, which means that this hose is frozen as well.
So we've got one tap in the house that works, and that's this tap here. So I'm having to fill up these basins and then put it in the washing machine. So in terms of drying the stuff, I've got these little infrared heaters in my bathroom because when you have a shower here, it's absolutely freezing otherwise. So yeah, you can see these two lights, but I'm gonna have to put up some sort of clothing rack. So using the handy rake, the rake comes in use quite often here. There you go, that's not that bad, is it?
Ta-da!
Very good.
So yeah, water's a problem. I haven't had a shower since the Chengdu trip, so I've been using a bucket for a bucket shower, but I can't wait for the pipes to unfreeze. So there's water and then there's food. Right, we're getting some vegetables, but they're all hidden underneath the snow, so we've got to find them somewhere.
Pandor.
Yeah. Here. Ah! Here.
Yeah. 3 sets of vegetables, we got it. And it's not just us humans who have been struggling, the animals have as well.
Well, Jing Jing, the bird whisperer. Ni hao, birdie. Tai lang la.
Yes.
The bird's too cold.
Poor geese look very cold.
What's going on?
We are taking bees. It's too cold.
It's too cold.
Okay.
Hello. Whoa, Jesus. So the cold hasn't stopped the training. In fact, you have to do it or else you freeze to death.
Indoor training with Jing Jing.
I'm not gonna let the cold stop me doing meditation outside, so I'm gonna do some standing meditation. I've got all my layers on. Let's do this. And I've also been doing Tai Chi training, listening to some music in the woods. Music is a massive part of my life. I listen to music all the time, and at home I play a bit of piano and hear sing badly. In fact, the very first video I did on this channel was about why humans love music. Check it out, that's some OG George content there. But one thing I've never been able to do is to dance. When I'm in the club with my mates at home, I can do like the two-step, but beyond that, I don't have any dance moves in my repertoire. So I've been loving Tai Chi because suddenly I've got this way to express myself with my body. And an especially fun part of the Tai Chi practice is changing the music. So when you change the music, you completely change the vibe of the Tai Chi. Let me show you what I mean. So let's start off with some classical. That's what you'd think about when you think about Tai Chi. You think slow moving, beautiful moves. And this is the Lark Ascending, an absolutely stunning piece of classical music. So with classical music, it's the most meditative form. You glide with the music and it's a wonderful feeling. You just get lost in it. But you can also try house and techno, because that's what I listen to at home. So yeah, it's a lot of fun. Leave me a song in the comments you think I would enjoy doing Tai Chi to. I'd like to see what your guys' suggestions are. Right, that's it. I hope you enjoyed. Right, back to editing. I hope my hands don't freeze off. See you next time.